All right, it's what time? 9:59 p.m. and I'm headed back to the west end from Southside. And I'm looking at, I know the people next to me are thinking about moving out, and the car next to me, but as soon as they started thinking about me, they're wondering why there's a screen on.
A service of Virginia Tech.
It's about, it's just a camp. Tell them I
when you were listening to the RR radio.
And I was just thinking too, I wish that was
the or was. And I looked up and I saw that crazy like tower thing that they have in that stadium.
And there we go. Don't mind the, is that Andrew? That looked like my, see, right, that, it probably wasn't, it may have been him, but like what I feel intuitively is that, yeah, this is somebody I've been trying to get in touch with, man. I keep feeling that I should get in touch and at least try to say hi, check in, even if I'm not around, hanging out all the time, like we all used to be. You know, Tony inspired me tonight a whole lot. I mean, like, he was, like, very upfront. But I haven't been in touch with him, you know, old-time friends, you know? I've been kind of, like, anti-socially, let's say, in a way. Like, not just being at home all the time, not going out, not even calling people like that. You know, like, sometimes going on Facebook, but a whole lot, a lot of time I don't. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm riding down Shippenham Parkway and there's construction going on to the left. That's why I got distracted by what was going on over there. It's like the way I was getting something strong. You can see smoke going up behind them and dust and stuff like that. And they're in the far left, like medium, doing something with various trucks. Almost like they're doing asphalt, but the thing is they're doing, they might do that as part of a big job, but in the end, I gotta make this video more understandable. You see what I go through, y'all? This is every day with me, you know, like all the time, it just is what it is, and anybody who's also psychic, also medium and empath as well, and there's plenty of people who understand, and they'll understand when I'm talking about you, you know, on the onslaught of energy from all of them. So sometimes you get even more fluid and stories going on around you with everyone and everything that, and, even the usual shit is that you gotta get used to, you know, learn how to multitask and feel it all. Y'all know what I mean, like, with all senses of your shit from around you, your proximity, wherever you might be, from people, from animals, from plants, from spirits, you know, that sense and all kinds of stuff all at the same time, people's thoughts, people's emotional state of the moment, all animals' thoughts and emotions. I've sensed trees, feelings, and what was going on with the trees' collective minds together, you know, because trees have spirits too, inhabit them. There's many who have recalled lifetimes as, for example, actually an oak tree, a maple tree, whatever kind, you know, like, and other kinds of plants, and animal past lives as well. I'm on it wasn't under hypnosis, the memories just came. I had some of them when I was very little. I knew exactly what they were, that they were real, and I knew that most people wouldn't understand. So I kept it mainly to myself, but I saw, like, my immediate past life before this one, and Westchester County and the suburbs, not far from the city called Brewster in that lifetime. And then I went for the city very young. I was still in my mid-teens, and I moved to Brooklyn. And I also moved to Staten Island and hung out over there quite a bit as well. But lived in let me give a good video here. I might cut into this in different parts. Everybody has like a musical kind of frequency to them. Every soul resonates like a combination of sounds. And that's a signature. You know, the universe assigns like basically a type of sound to everything out there to give it like an ID. You know, a tag, you know, a role in the grand scheme of cosmic wheel. All the experiences and possible possibilities, having the opportunity to live out various variations of life, the way things could have gone if you changed your mind, your thought patterns, you know, or the way you can experience it now, you know, or you can pretend to take time to get to certain types of lives, certain places, or you can hop all around in one life. You're in, you're a female, and you're relaxed and you live in this New York or LA or wherever it may be, or Africa somewhere, that African country, you know, or Canada, you know. And the in the next life you live in Mexico or New Zealand and you're male and you have issues. About, let's say, one life you're super smart, the next life, you know, you choose to experience another type of lifetime. Like, you know, experience what it's like to have your brain not all there, or whatever it might be, you know? Like people choose to have physical abilities in their lifetime, souls choose them. Souls choose to have disabled bodies before they're born. Souls choose, you know, if they're going to be homeless and poor their whole lives, you know, in their upcoming physical life, or if they're going to be billionaires, like, and they have guidance from other spirit selves and the spirit dimensions, and making choices, planning out life at all. Or lives sometimes, multiple lives are planned at once, and then you jump immediately from one to the other without a break. That's also planned out in fantasy. The soul chooses that there's kind of lives. It's like a soul might choose a tree lifetime, and your soul is going to do it in order to learn patience and acceptance and stuff like that. And by not being able to being there conscious inside a tree, just like a soul's in a human body, for example, as well. And animals have souls, insects have types of souls. Soul is a word that can be interpreted various ways. I prefer spirit soul, you know, to soul. Because, like, it's a spirit self. Okay, there goes a pong card. Okay. Two pawn cars in a row, and I'll explain what that is. Have a light screen. Here comes another pawn. This is how I live too. Oppo pawns, like, you know, always driving around, and I can pick them up. And they're genetically altered to be, but the great majority to be telepathically more receptive to everyone around them, and most of them. At the same time, engineered to have the emphasis on picking up strong, not projecting it out on that strong. But that's not the case with everyone, of course. Every one of the pawns out there that operates on Aubrey's pawns. But with plenty of human pawns, you know, it's I'll get into this other thing later time. Alright, see, I'm not even worried about this. See, like, I'm feeling my mom right now. I'm driving her van tonight. You know, I borrowed a van, and then she called, like, wanted to get the van back to her house quickly. And I knew that, like, hey, it's not that critical. But I'm not that late. Okay, there's the Oppo. I saw this the other thing. There's two trucks right there. I've seen one before. And there's people sitting on. I see this routine. This is routine. Okay, now one of this started it. See, this is what happened. This is how it did for as long as I can remember. Yeah, no, I mean, so it's an Oppo doing other things. But when you're teaching truth, hell yeah, you're going to get the Oppo pawns and all kinds of stuff, you know. So, it's just, it is what it is. So, and she wants to be, like, also to help put my brothers in a wheelchair and to bed for the night while I'm over here. So, let's park the car over here. I'm going to continue this video inside shortly. I'll try to take care of everything. Alright, y'all, see you next time.